Hey everybody, so we have a bunch of vacuums in front of you here for your viewing pleasure. Lots of vacs to run through, a little time to do it in. It's like 11 o'clock at night, and I'd really like to go to bed after all the driving I've done today. But as you see in the back, we have the three conquests that I showed the other day, and there are the three other conquests not seen before. This is the wide path with either the fan or bearing issue. This one. Yeah, this is the one I think the armature is shot on, and that's the one I have yet to do anything with because I just grabbed the carbons off it to put in one that I figured would work. That one looks like the wires are in bad condition, so I don't know, but I'm gonna try it. But I think I'm out of carbons because I put all the good carbons in the remaining machines, and I think I have three carbon holders sitting around that need new brushes, so I guess I gotta go to the store on Friday because I'm not gonna have any time tomorrow and get new carbons. But it doesn't look like I'm gonna have any time Friday either because I got a lot of work to do, especially with all these new vacuums to work on. But anyway, I paid a long needed visit to Kyle, if you know Kyle. He's probably a more prominent collector than me. I don't know who has more machines, but might be me. Because I have a lot of junk, and he doesn't have a lot of junk. He's got a lot of nice machines. Let's say I have a lot of nice machines too. But anyway, if you know Kyle, he gave me all the other vacuums unspoken for yet sitting here. He said I paid him a long needed visit that we planned on because I picked up, I can never remember what it's called, Kenmore Power Mage or something like that for him that I saw on sale a while back when I was interested in getting some Hoovers that this idiot had. And we've been working on this, and each of us has been holding it off till we've been available. Now we finally got to it and got down to business, you know. But anyway, it seems every time I meet a new collector, I walk away with a lot of vacs. Feel very fortunate for that, because I mean, it certainly does show there are some very nice, generous people out there. Not to say I'm not generous, but I'm not one to get rid of vacs. Even if they're in dire condition, I'll make something out of them if I can. Bring them to the highest point of restoration that I can get to. But anyway, he had lots of nice vacs in his house. Some almost as nice, probably if not as nice, vacs in his shed, either awaiting being fixed or just as extra storage. And he told me to walk away with a couple of them. Figured I'd repurpose them better, which I will. The starts were these two filter queen canisters. Now I know nothing about filter queens besides they're supposed to be good and they're these cute looking little tanks that roll around. Obviously I can tell that one's older than that one. This one he says has a rare built-in cord rewinder in its base. You take it off the base, which now it doesn't want to come off. Before it wouldn't stay on. Anyway, the base comes off and in the base is a automatic cord rewinder. Push that little button and the cord rewinds. I'll take his word for it, it's rare. This one has a power nozzle port. That'll probably be my favorite just because it has a power nozzle port. And I'm assuming this isn't the original upholstery nozzle for that. I don't know. I'm assuming it would have been brown or something. And I don't know what attachments, what else they're supposed to come with. But I mean, it certainly is an honor to have them, be given them by a fellow collector. And then there's the hose. I assume that hose goes with this one. Here's all those parts I bought with the Conquests. In this box is a bunch of brush rolls. I think that's under that is all sorts of rubber parts and stuff. And then I don't even know what the hell heck else is in there. I reorganized it all on Sunday morning. And this one was a little last minute that he surprised me and threw it in there, and I am very grateful for, is an Elite 300 with the Kmart style bag, just like my 6.0. Very, very nice machine. This will definitely be a prize of my collection. And a 10 amp Phantom Thunder in a greenish color. I'm sure this is one of the rare ones. He says the motor doesn't work. I'm gonna try to tinker with it, see what I can get done on it. I'll figure something out. And this is basically just a base of a Dirt Devil. Said the motor shot. Who knows? I might tinker with it. Maybe I'll get something out of it. Probably not. But it's definitely good for the housing because my 7200 has a bad housing and gave me a bag door to go with it. This is definitely an oldie, a Westinghouse with a cord that's definitely seen better days. So we're gonna definitely or first give it a wash, then get it running, then polish it up. I don't know if that's supposed to be polished or not. I'll get it polished. And the handle's busted off, so I get to be creative and make something with that. Nice concept one. My first non-self-propelled model. I think this is an 82 though. Same color red as mine. This is the first concept that I've ever seen a brush roll melt into the housing and completely melt the bristles and the plastic beater bars on the brush roll. Somehow the brush roll, I don't know which side the belt side is. Anyway, whatever side the belt side is, snapped the brush roll back and the thing continued to spin and it wore right through the plastic housing and right through the brush roll. It was amazing that the thing was still spinning and the belt was still going with it being digging that far into the thing. Again, I'll get creative with that and I'll probably put a little screw in the side right where the melted housing is not supposed to be melted and replace the brushes with the some worn out ones that I got sitting around because there's nothing left of one side, and this thing should run. And this I traded for my Bissell power partner. He wanted a power partner, I wanted the power amp, so we traded it. His somebody got brilliant and took the tool caddy off or broke it off and used those easy remove, I don't know, three, yeah, like the 3M easy remove hooks because we were looking at it and we're like, those are weird cord hooks. This thing should have a tool caddy on it. And then I looked at it and I'm like, no, those are. Those are like those 3M hooks. And sure enough, we grabbed them and ripped them off, and that's what they were. So we swapped my tool caddy and hose on it. And I still got to put a better screw in the back there. But and it needs a handle release spring, which I'll fix that hopefully tomorrow. I'd like to get to fixing some of these tomorrow. Is there any other vacuums here? The Regina. That one I just found out when I opened the door looked like a mouse or mice had been living in it. Almost deja vu like my truck. So I guess that one's not just going to get a bag and a belt and a cleanup. It's going to get a full motor tear down to see what other damage they've done. I've already seen that they chewed through the headlight wiring. Little fucking bastards like to chew shit that they shouldn't. So yeah, there's that. I mean, obviously, those they'll just need to clean up. I think the filters are in pretty good shape. They'll get a nice cleanup. I assume I can polish the metal parts. And I'm missing, you know, these damn little ladybugs. I'm gonna kill these little pricks. Oh, looks like the tool caddy's cracked. Guess I'll get to glue that. Figure out how that's supposed to properly go in there. I'll get them all fixed. I always do. I mean, I was hoping to start on the Conquest, but I'd rather go through all the lovely machines I got from him first because I've had my fill of Conquest for a while. So, there's all the new vacs, and hope you enjoyed them.